Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Crusader Kings 2. It is I, the Golden Joeblivion. We're back with Lord Paramount Rickard Stark of the North. And last episode, we declared a war for the Fist of the First Men. We are trying to reclaim all of the significant holy sites for the old gods' religion. Why? Because we can reform the religion. We can reform it in a manner where it's going to make it easier for us to take the Iron Throne. At least, that was the theory. I don't know if that's actually going to be possible, but of the comments, so I've been getting a lot of comments lately, and I have not been doing my due diligence as far as responding to them all or even reading them all, but I do know that someone suggested that with the Reform religion, we could go down the path of the God King, which that's just a cool title. It's just a cool title. Let me see what it says, actually. The Reformer will become the new head of the religion and be worshipped as a god. This will radicalize followers between supporters and opponents of this. Our ruler walks as a god among us and must be worshipped as such. Let's see. Character exists, yes, is a feudal royal monarch. Oh, so we would have to be independent. We'd have to be a king. We can't be a god king if we're not even a king. Will radicalize followers between supporters of the faith. I wonder what that would offer us. It would make Lord Paramount Rickard Stark a god king, though, which would be cool. Worship of the Seven? I don't think so. I'm leaning away from divine marriage and polygamy because that's what I would normally pick, and that's really, really popular, but I just don't see that being very helpful for us in our purposes here. What is stability? It is blasphemous to doubt the legitimacy of a ruler who has come to power under the favor of the gods. He should be shown immediate loyalty by his subjects. Short reign penalty is disabled. Rulers can spend piety to improve their quarters' attributes. Realm, province, revolt risk is reduced. I mean, that's okay. I am thinking more. Ooh, adoption. I'm thinking meritocracy. So we can just pick and choose who our heirs are going to be. So we can pick whoever is the best person. Blood ties need not be of the sole requirement of rulership. Being adopted in family also is sufficient in the god's eyes. Interesting. Maybe adoption. What is ancestor veneration? The religious head can decide upon dead ancestors to give special status, enables eldership succession laws. Interesting. I don't know what animism is. Ritual sacrifice can unlock special traits and actions. I imagine is a lot like the sacrifice for the drowned god or something like that. However, blood magic could be also really, really useful. But there's no dragons around at the moment, so the powers behind that would be diminished. But I think it would still be important if we were to get it set up to where we can actually reform the religion. And what we need, moral authority must be at least 50%. You only control two of the old god holy sites. You need at least three. We need at least 750 piety. We can probably get 750 piety here. Oh, absolutely. Studying intensively, honorable. Oh, easy. That'll be easy to get. Now, what I'm thinking, for some reason, my brain is telling me that if we controlled all the holy sites, that we wouldn't need to have 50% moral authority. At least, that's what it was when I reformed the Weeping Lady religion down in Lys in my little personal playthrough. We took over all of the holy sites, and we didn't need to have 50% moral authority. But it says we need at least three. Reform the old guy would turn into an organized religion unless you control all of the holy sites. Doing so requires 50 moral authority and control the three old god sites. Okay, and we get moral authority through winning battles and stuff like that. Rulers converted 3%, lost a minor war. Okay, so we can convert people too. Interesting. If that's the case, do we have someone who is doing conversion right now? No. You're only performing charity. Now, are you you're just a scientist. Okay, you don't actually have to be a priest. Let's go down here and see if we can invite someone who's got a really high learning skill. Who can be a priest? Edwin! You! We will accept you. Stormsinger. Interesting, we'll take him. Nice. Something else is missing. Your court physician. Yeah, why don't we have a court physician? Interesting. Send for a maester from the Citadel. Fine, do it. Young Edot is developing an arbitrary streak. It's showing more clearly every day. He cannot be arbitrary. That is an awful, awful, awful trait. So let's get, ambitious. Yeah, okay, well, it's good for Edard personally, but that means that when we're playing as Brandon, Edard's gonna be kind of a little bitch, because he's gonna be ambitious. He's gonna want to rise up, which is not like Lord Edard was in the lore. But he's ambitious this time around. So what can we do? What can you do? Anyways, get timer going. Marching all of our armies. My southern armies aren't really. Oh, right. We can't invade with all of our armies because this territory is beyond the wall. Interesting. Young Brandon is developing an arbitrary streak. No, and he's arbitrary. God damn it, Brandon. Damn it. That's gonna make it even harder. I don't know how to get rid of arbitrary. Maybe if we picked the rulership focus and then prayed that we would get the event that would make us just. So I think the rulership focus gives you the chance. I know it gives you the chance to become stressed, but it also gives you the chance to get the just trait, which I think is the opposite of arbitrary. Could be worth trying. Oh yes, he's joined us. Our new Storm Singer. Really? Storm Singer? What the fuck? Why is he a Storm Singer? You shouldn't be a Storm Singer. Priest Harris. And apparently... Oh, god damn it. See, you have got 12 learning, right? If we were to employ a priest, 16 gold. Jesus Christ. Never mind. I don't want to employ anybody. Oh, now I have to employ somebody. Oh, great. Great. Clay has joined us, and he has only 10. Great. He's even worse. I got gypped. You're going to proselytize, and you're going to start converting people, because that's going to give us more moral authority over time. Thank you. We have a maester now. Super. What is this? Call allies into a Lord Paramount Hustler of the Trident. Now, your friend Lord Howard has sent you a gift. It is a small puppy, but of the finest pedigree, destined to grow into a great hunting dog. Does he got the hunting focus? No, we do. Okay. Excellent. I will accept this gracious gift. Super. What are we going to name the dog? Dash. I like that. Dash. I wish I could remember the name of the direwolves, the Stark direwolves. Well, I know one of them was named Ghost, another one was named Summer, but I don't remember the rest of the names. We'll just keep it at Dash. Whatever. Anyways, so our personal armies are here, right? Yep. This is we're personal army. Where is this one? We'll arrive in Eastwatch over here. No, that's the Shadow Tower. You're gonna go over here. Jesus. And anyways, doesn't matter. Who dare conspires? No one is conspiring. Nobody's conspiring, Wyman. Just relax. All right. Go ahead and march on the Fist of the First Men. I don't care if we have 3,000 men that are all gonna starve. Doesn't matter to me. This is more important. This is a war for our faith. All right. Go ahead and merge these soldiers here. This should be an easy to win war. And we're marching alone into this battle. Brendan. We need help. Yes, okay. I just don't want to be the only commander fighting. And we're facing off against High Chief Devin the Hornblower. Okay. Give me 2 more days, and we are going to storm. Your son Brandon is responding very well to my tuition. He gains 2 stewardship and patience. Super. Excellent. Now then, take the Fist of the First Men. So now we have 29%. Are we going to get a war score? Oh, we can. Yes, we will, because we control the fist of the First Men. So let's go ahead and just all out invade, and because they're wildlings, we can pour over the border with all of our men. So you guys march down to Cruster's Winterkeep. Actually, it's not Cruster's Keep. And then you guys march over to Fork Top, the Skirling Pass, just all-out invasion. Now, are the ice rivers a part of the domain of our enemy here? Let's see here. No, it's just this here. Excellent. But I will march the rest of you. Well, I say I'm going to march the rest of you. You, and you guys go down to the new gift. Excellent. Easy war. Anyways, I'm probably going to pull us out of command because I want us to be back in Winterfell. I don't want to get cheesed by any kind of game mechanics here. Lord Brandon is almost of age. Betrothed Camari. Do it. Dash is going quickly. It is no longer a little puppy. Excellent. 1,000 prestige. Nice. All right. Lord Paramount Morin of the Reach. Let's see. It was Garland. Luther. He died in an accident. Super. So can we get an alliance with you now? No, because he doesn't really like us. We need to sway him into liking us more. Lord Brandon Stark and Janna Tyrell have gotten married. I would like you to pay us. I'd like us... greedy bastard. You son of a bitch. News from the Battle of Winterkeep, my lord. Your bannerman, Lord Roderick Flint, has been slain. Oh. Oh, yeah, that's quite the force here. Go ahead and back up and destroy them. back up, and destroy them. During his visit to my court, the Master of Laws of the Iron Throne, Lord Primaquillan of the Iron Isles, has really convinced me of what a benevolent and peaceful ruler his liege King Rhaegar is. All lies, of course. King Rhaegar would never be a good ruler. Lies. Alright, crushing the wildlings. Very nice. Very nice. And then they give me the chance to invade the Winter Keep. Yep, do it. Though of somewhat dubious providence, Lord Roos III of the Dreadfort has presented me with evidence that Blink is plotting treason against me. I don't think Kevin is doing that, because he's honorable. Roos, on the other hand, I have a stronger feeling that you are actually the one who's sowing dissent, Roos. Roos Bolton. Just gonna march this huge horde. Ooh, hey, what is this? We surrender under these terms. Let's see, Lord Paramount can choose either to usurp or vassalize the Rickard Stark. What? All right, some crazy tooltip bugs here. Lord Paramount Rickard can choose either to usurp or vassalize the Rickard Stark. So that's some. But it says he's surrendering. It doesn't say he's offering a white piece. So we're going to accept. Oh, we have 100. Well, if that's the case, if we have 100, then fuck that. We're gonna send you our terms. And I've still gotten more bugs. Interesting. This should be giving me the Fist of the First Men. We have successfully seized the chiefdom of the Fist of the First Men after defeating High Chief Devon Hallowbluff of the Milkwater. Shall this territory be attached to the personal domains of Winterfell? Or shall Chief Mance Heartcut be confirmed as its rightful holder to ensure stability? He can swear fealty to me. I will take it for myself. Gets new administration, it gets recently conquered. No, we will take it for ourselves. Excellent. So what kind of supply limit do we have here? 20k. Are you mad? Really? 20k. Alright, march all of our armies there. Nice. And then disband everyone else that we don't need. ASAP, please. We didn't raise our personal levies there because we wanted to be able to make some money with our, make some money for our treasury here because we need to build that up as well. Go ahead and get rid of those guys. Excellent. And then all of you guys can probably just stay. It's like stay in the north. Avoid the Night's Watch. But we now control the Fist of the First Men. Which gives us, what is this? Won a minor war, plus 1%, rulers converted. And I don't see any kind of timer or anything for these percentages, so I don't know if they're permanent or if they go away eventually. Fist of the First Men, the holy site is not held by a member of the Old God's faith. The Weirwood of the First Men. The Cold God's faith consider this a holy site. Okay, so it doesn't really matter. Okay, so how do we take this though? Weirwood of the First Men. You are a beyond the wall gods. Can we kill you? He is a genius though. But despite that, his stats are still pretty bad, except for his learning. Can we imprison you? Can we kill you? We can. I don't really want to plot though. Should we fabricate claims? What can we do with that? I want to make sure that the person who's got the holy site here is actually of the Old God's faith. Well, you know what we can do? Proselytize. There we go. Proselytize in the Fist of the First Men. Because their religion is beyond the wall old gods. We need them to be just old gods. All right, then down here is going to be the capital, and it is the crown focus. Excellent. Disband armies here. And I suppose this army here we can also disband, right? Yep, we can get rid of that. Excellent. Now go ahead and get this timer, because I want to get these people disbanded and everything. My dear liege, I was approached by Mago Frey, who tried to convince me to join her file heresy. I will engage him in theological debate. Yes. All right. It's hard to think about. Okay, so we're trying to get Lord Paramount Morvin? Morvin. Morvin? Yes. No, Morin. It's Morin. God damn it. I kept seeing a V and a Y in there. Write him a letter about me. Send him one of my statues. Let's send him one of my statues. Excellent. And we've converted Mago Frey to the old gods. Nice. All right, go ahead and disband. And he really liked our statues. Excellent. As he should. Alrighty. After years of careful planning, Brynden Tully has raised a large army of exiles, mercenaries, and hopefuls, declaring his intention to press his claim by force. If you all remember, in a previous episode, we funded Brendan Tully's claim on, I believe, the Trident. And the reason we did that was because the current ruler of the Trident, Lord Paramount Hoster the Eloquent, he doesn't really like us. I mean, it's 13, but we were trying to sway him, and we couldn't. We were struggling to do that. He was very resistant to our attempts at swaying. So we figured, since the Blackfish is so awesome already, if we helped him press his claim for the Trident, he would become the new lord of Riverrun and the Trident, and he would love us and would most definitely probably become a staunch ally. We're already allies with Lord Paramount Hoster the Eloquent, though. But now Brendan Tully marches on the south with 7,000 men. Now, is that enough to actually beat? It might not be enough. Brendan, do you need more gold, sir? He's still refusing marriage requests, but I think we can send him more gold. And I know it's not going to do anything for his disposition towards us, but it is going to increase his treasury, which would make it even easier for him to hire more men. So let's just go ahead and start pumping him full of money. Money, get him over 100. Make ourselves go nearly broke for that. Okay, now he's marching on the south. Excellent. I wonder if we couldn't join him. Could we join your war? No, we can't. My lord, I've been instructing young Benjen the ways of sword and lance. Benjen is too soft. Unfortunate. Lady Liana. She is betrothed to Albert Aaron. Yes. But apparently that marriage isn't going to establish us any kind of alliance with the Vale, which is why we betrothed her to begin with. And is she married? Married. No, she's still betrothed. Somebody suggested that we break the betrothal because Lord Paramount Rickard is actually ambitious, and he would have no problem breaking that betrothal. This will lower Lord Paramount Joffrey II of the Vale's opinion of you by minus 20. I don't want that. I don't want that. Honorable prestige. But we also can't get an alliance either. Is a close relative or has a non-aggression pact. We can't get a non-aggression pact with him. Interesting. Maybe it's because he's 4 years old. Damn it. I am really thinking that we need to break this betrothal here. And the reason that is because we need more Starks. We only have eight members of House Stark, and that's pretty low. That's a pretty low number. I generally like to have over 10. So I think I am going to break this betrothal. Lord Paramount Joffrey II of the Vale is going to hate us, but he's only 4 years old. And what we're going to do is, we can Lord Paramount Jaime of the Westerlands. You don't say. Would he be willing to arrange a betrothal with Liana? He would. So he really likes Lord Paramount Rickard. He likes the age of Lady Liana. He doesn't like her skills, but he really likes the prestige effects and the difference in age. She's 10, and he's 4, which means he'll be 6 years younger than her at any one time. He's already going to really, really dislike us because of broken betrothal to 82 for 10 years. For 10 years, he's going to dislike us for that. Which, by that point, he'll be 14. Fuck it. Do it. We need the Vale. All right. Hopefully, this will secure the Vale. I'm hoping. I have decided to accept your suggestion. Good. Now will you form an alliance, you son of a bitch? No, because you don't like us. Can we give you gold? A message about a signed guardian. Rhaegar wants to become the guardian. Who is Lady Catelyn? She's married to Sir Raymond Dargood. You want Brandon to be the ward? I don't think so, sir. I don't think so. We're not going to do that. Anyways. Ooh. My bodyguard, Sir Wallace, he wants to get married. Okay, we will find somebody for you. You can marry Melara. She's 44. You finished your study on the Art of War and hopefully have learned something in the process. All right. I'm assuming we've done everything we can with our personal study. What else can we do? Go on a grand hunt? Of course you could. Known plots. Kill Lord Hother of the White Knife. Brandon is developing into an ambitious young man. Good for him. As he should. Expressed consternation at the fact Tomard enjoys command. See, he's got 13. You have 11. My lord, you make a good point. And he is a lord, though. But he's the lord of Breakstone Hill. Yeah, he's a lord. All right, let him have it. I accept your suggestion that Sir Wylas and Malara get married. That's good. Now, I don't think we can offer to join war. We could join his war, couldn't we? Interesting. Who is idle? It's probably... Yeah, Kevin. Kevin is idle. So, where could we send him? We can send him just about anywhere. We could send him just about anywhere. But. What are the other holy sites? Harrenhal, Storm's End. Storm's End is important to the old gods. Oh yeah, it would be, wouldn't it? Yeah, because the old gods were technically all over the continent of Westeros before the Andal showed up. I think it goes something like that. Harrenhal, Storm's End. Which means if we can get Harrenhal and we can get Storm's End, and just through fabricating claims and fighting our fellow Lord Paramounts, which Rhaegar won't like. What is the Realm Authority like? It's medium, so he could tell us to stop. Harrenhal's down here, and it is ruled by House Wendt. Then Storm's End's down here, and it's ruled by House Baratheon. Jesus. That would be hard to get. Storm's End would be hard to get. Unless we can somehow trick them through marriage to give us Storm's End. And then we would only need 750 piety, and then we could reform the religion. Ooh, but we would have to become independent before that as well. Shit. Overthrow the monarchy of the Iron Throne. That would make us a king. Would it make us a king? It wouldn't make us a king. It would make us a Lord Protector or something. Ooh. Rule the Iron Throne or reform the religion. I'm not actually sure. Yes, Kevin is the one who is idle. He is the one that is idle. I'm not sure, because I originally started the miniseries here to see how Stark get on the Iron Throne. But now I really want to reform the religion so we can become a God King. I wonder if there isn't some way we can do both. But, ladies and gentlemen, that's going to have to be the end of this episode. It's a little shorter than normal. I've got 3 episodes I got to record today, so I'm keeping them a bit short this time around. Everything else you'll have to see happen in the next episode. Thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and share the video. I have been the Golden Joeblivion. This has been Lord Paramount Rickard of the North. And until next time, I will see you all later.